We have to find a way out of here.
And then?
And then we get our hands on the cloaking device and finish what we started.
All right. Let's say you manage to save this Grand Nagus of yours. Then what?
Then we go home. And never come back here again.
That's it?
Isn't it enough?
Quark, don't play dumb with me. You're risking your life for him. There has to be a reason for it.
He's the Nagus. He's the man my mother loves, not to mention he's the head of the Ferengi Alliance.
In other words, he's rich.
They don't come any richer.
I see. How much are you expecting to get out of him?
Knowing the Nagus, I'd say a pat on the head and a fistful of empty promises.
I don't understand.
There's nothing to understand. He's my Nagus. And when your Nagus gets in trouble, you're supposed to do something about it.
Why?
I don't know. Loyalty.
You're kidding me, right? You're doing this out of loyalty?
Would you stop looking at me like that? You're making me feel like an idiot.
I hope so.
Brother, I just realized something.
This should be good.
This is supposed to be an alternate universe, but their Captain O'Brien seems as nice as our Chief O'Brien.
So?
Don't you see? It doesn't make any sense. It's not alternate.
Go back to sleep, Ron.
Right. But it's all very confusing. What was that?
How would I know?
Brother, look out at the front!
I don't think it's our brunt.
What took you so long?
Sorry. Been a little busy. I had to break into the cargo bay, steal back the cloaking device that you lost, and get it into our ship. But on top of that...
Okay, quit your complaining and get us out of here.
I'm working on it. You two must be hungry. I've got food and drink waiting for you on the ship.
He's so nice.
Scary, isn't it?